Thank you for watching this video. Today I will investigate an issue I have with electric folding mirror on a Mitsubishi Delica 1994, so Space Gear, that we bought 1 month ago roughly. That just wonderful car, but some, yeah, there's some little issues with that, including this one mirror. So I will try to show you the two way where the problem could come from, and yeah, how to fix that. Should be quite straightforward, to be honest. So let's see. Issue you might have is the same as me. So if you go there, and of course you have your mirror there, and you try to fold it, and you've got nothing despite the keys on. So it's on, nothing happening, and you cannot set your mirror also. In this case, so the issue might come from this part. So we are going to remove it and see what is underneath. The things you need to do is to check how many screws you have that hold this panel. So here we have only one screw, so I will just remove it. It's just a Phillips screw. The screw is removed, so you can see here, and that's everything. So to remove this panel, you have to be careful. So you need to lift at the back here, but there's a clip at the front, so you need to pull, lift back and pull along the door, and it should come, yeah, here it is. And if you lift, you see this sensor, this button there under, you have like a blue, and here it is. So this one is fairly easy. You have a connector, so I don't know if you can see that there's this white connector under, which is basically unplugged. So I will just clip that back and we see that works. Put back in place. I don't know why it was not plugged, so I will just leave it like that for now, and we'll try to put the contact on, and let's try to fold the mirror. Yes, that works. Okay, the other one also. Yes. Perfect. Straightforward, to be honest. So now to put back the driver control panel, the driver's door control panel in place, so you just like reverse. So you will need to clip the panel back at the front and then put down, and it should clip, and then just put back the screw. Let's do that. So the clip is there, the back, and it's in place. Here you can see there is no gap here. So that's clean. Okay. So the screw is back in place. So now let's just try to play with the setting. So I select the right mirror. Okay, so that works. Let's put it back, something like that. The left one does the job. Okay, on the folding, they do work. Super. I'll show you where I was thinking my issue was coming from at the beginning. So it was not on the driver's side, driver's door control panel, but around the relay. So the relay for the electric folding mirror. I was thinking this relay was dead, so yeah, so that's where I was going to investigate. So let's see. If you need to access the electric folding mirror relay, it is located on the left side of the car, at the front, so like the passenger side, if you have a right-hand drive. This relay is located behind the speaker, and behind the glove box. Looking at the passenger side, so lovely view. And the relay we are talking about is behind this one, but like not just behind this because it's a speaker, but behind the speaker. So you access it by the glove box, which is there. So we need to remove the glove box, or at least detach it first, and then we can access the relay, and then we'll check there. Empty the glove box. And the glove box holds with those two plastic bits here and there. It's like plastic hooks that are going behind to hold the glove box in place. So to detach them, so you just need to slide them. It's quite bit difficult, but I will need my two hands there, so I will switch off. But you need to slide them there, and then they will just fall, so they will be free, they will be loose. So I've detached them. So to detach this one, so you just put your finger behind and you just push it, and then you will clip, let's say unclip. You have a little hole there, so that keeps things in place. I will do the focus properly. Okay, so now you need to just leave the glove box. I do that with my foot, and you can just turn by 90 degrees the clip, and it should come. Here it is. So it's just a clip. It's very easy. And the same on the other side. Up. So I just turn it. So down or up, don't care. I should not put them there. Up. And it is. So the glove box is out of the way, so we can see everything inside. There's a cooling unit there. There's a fan. And there's this relay. So this part number MB852142, which is Mitsubishi part number, that's the relay that controls the mirror. So this relay is easily available on internet if you need to buy one. So I've got a spare one, which is the same part number, which I get from a Mitsubishi FTO. So it's also the same relay that is used on different platforms, so different models. So just get the part number and that will work fine. So I will try to show what is happening if your relay doesn't work properly. Relay by itself holds in place just with one screw here, which is quite easy to remove. Up, be careful not to lose it, because it's quite a pain to get it afterwards. Up, here it is. Just up. So it's just a normal screw. And you can catch your relay, so be careful not pulling too hard on all the connection, all the other connection. And you have one connector here. So sorry for the other one, which is behind. Up, should not be there, this one. Go back where you are with the other wire out of the way. So you can see there's just one connector that's connected to this relay. So this metallic part is just a bracket, it's not grounded, nothing. So it's just single bracket. So you can just, if you need to detach it, you just press there and that should go. I might need both my hands. No, you need to press the black one, and that should go. Up, let's play a bit with that, and here it is. So, we have our relay. So let's say, what is happening if the relay was not working? We're going to check that in the next sequence, so the same part number. What happen if your just the relay is not working? So I've just basically disconnected the relay. We know that this connector is now connected. So if we try to fold the mirror, nothing is happening. Okay. However, if you try to set your mirror, so I'm selecting the right one, that works. Okay, so then you have, depending on the diagnostic, we'll see, we'll summarize at the end, but if your relay is dead, then you can set your mirror, but you cannot fold them. If the issue comes from those buttons there, then you have nothing at all. That means you cannot fold the mirror and you cannot send them either. On the passenger seat, I'm going to reconnect whichever I've got. So I've got two relays. This one was in place, so I'm going to connect this one. It doesn't make a big difference, to be honest. So in order to put it back, so it's quite straightforward also. So you just have your plugs there, your socket, sorry. You've got the plug. So you just have to connect things together. That should clip. That clipped. And now you need, so sorry it's a bit dark, but you need to just put in place, you have, sorry for the focus, which is kind of weird. In the middle of this bracket, you have like where you have little hole and there's little hook there. You just need to go there. If I can get the focus right, it would be nice. La. And then it's in place. And you just need to put back this the screw from earlier. So I will just try to put it by hand first. That's in my hairy arm. And that's everything. Okay, next I will just finish with screwdriver. You don't need to tighten too much, just by hand. And then if we try, I hope it's a good relay. Contact is on. Sorry, an early fall. Touching that. And it works. Okay. So, if, as me, you didn't add anything, so that means you cannot fold your electric mirror and you cannot set them also. So it's most likely that the issue is coming from the switch or the button on the driver door control panel. So mine was pretty straightforward. It was just a, just unplug, don't know why. Otherwise, if you can set the mirror but it doesn't fold, it's most likely the relay which is in fault. So then, yeah, you can get a spare one. You can try to fix it if you have knowledge in electronic, but I mean, if you pay for 10, 12 quids, I pay mine 12 quids, so it's plenty enough. I mean, that's quite cheap, so you can just go with that. Changing it, so that takes 5 minutes. 10 minutes is that the first time you're trying to remove the glove box and everything, but it's that's an easy job. What else to say? So now everything's working fine, so I will just put back the glove box together. That should be done. Put one clip back already. For the second one, as you can see, you have this square section on the dot. So the clip by itself is like that. So you just put it back there, like that. So you need to push back a bit the glove to go behind the stop. Oops, sorry for the... So you need to put it back there, if it's okay to go, because I'm not far enough. Up. Là. So if you go far enough, then it will just go through. You need to be after the rail, and then you just push on it, it clips, and it's in place. So yeah, I will stop now because I just put back our stuff in the glove box and close everything. Okay, so I think it's time to conclude this video, so with the sun now. As you might have guessed, so I'm using my phone right now to record. My camera is in France, unfortunately, so, and that's the COVID-19 crisis, so yeah, I cannot travel, so hopefully at some point I will get it back. I will be able to do some, let's say, more professional record. But yeah, phone is okay for a start. So that's the first video I've posted on my YouTube channel. So temporary name is Knowledgeable Frenchman. So let's see if I keep that. Found it funny, but maybe a bit too much. If you found this video useful, please, give it a like. That's always useful. And feel free to follow my channel also. So that's a start. So I'm planning to post more videos later on different. I've owned 4 different cars, so there's a lot of stuff to say around them. So some classic and some let's say more modern ones. And plus, I'm quite interested in a lot of different topics, subjects. So could be quite various. So I will try to keep it tidy on the channel. And I think that's all. So I would like to thank you again for watching. Hopefully you will manage to fix your electric folding mirror with this video. One last thing. So if you're like me, so you like to watch video to prepare your work, but when you start doing your work, I try to get a paper copy of the instruction, like step by step. So I've taken some pictures also, and I will post the link under the video for, let's say, printable tutorial, so that you could use. So that will go on. I've got a personal webpage, so that will go to my website, so you can download it and just use it. The same, feel free to put a comment if you find something. Maybe there will be some mistakes in it, so just feel free to let me know if there's something to be amended. Okay, so that's all for now. So wish you all the best, stay safe, and hopefully I will get a new video soon. Bye.